In this tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to do camera perspective matching in Blender using the manual process. We will use this table reference image at its dimensions. So let's get started. This is the default setup in Blender. First, I'm going to create a bounding box with the dimensions of the table. In the front view, I'm going to select the cube and change the Z location to 1. Because I want the cube to be on the top of the grid. Next, I'm going to set the dimensions. Here the height is along the Z axis. Just type 75 cm and it will automatically convert to meters. Oops, this position is not correct. Because the pivot point of this cube is at the center, it should be at the bottom of the object. Just undo the action, then right click and set the origin to the 3D cursor. Now I'm going to set the dimensions. Height is along the Z axis, width is along the Y axis, and depth is along the X axis. Now the dimensions are set. You can see the bounding box shape of the table. Next, just press Shift plus T to duplicate, then press M to create a new collection and move this cube to it for the bounding box. Then click on the cube, go to Object Properties and in the viewport display, change texture to wire. Then I'm going to lock this. Go to the Outliner, Filter and just enable the selectable option, then disable it. Now you cannot select the cube. Next, select the camera and go to the Properties, enable the Background Image option and add an image by clicking Open to select the reference image. Just press 0 on the numpad. You can see the reference image, but it might look stretched. In the settings, change the stretch option to fit. Now the camera is locked, but if you want to unlock it, go to the sidebar and in the view selection, just enable the lock camera to view option. Now you can rotate, pan and zoom your camera freely. Now I'm going to adjust the camera manually. You can adjust the focal length to easily achieve the perspective matching. It might be a bit difficult, but if you are a beginner, you can practice. Once experienced, you can use free add-ons. Now the perspective is matched. Next, I'm going to start the modeling. The modeling is done and you can try some practice on your own. I hope this video has been helpful for you. Please support my YouTube channel.